In the DFW area, yeah.
Okay.
I believe he's probably. Yeah, I can't think of any other one.
Yeah, okay.
Other than I think Andy replaced Wario, but other than those two, I can't think of any more.
Okay, yeah, I'm just making sure because I've played Andy Rue before. I played Oryx in bracket today, and like he's really good, man. Like he's stupid good at this game. Really puts a lot of time into it, and we're gonna get the game right now. Oryx doesn't have enough time to celebrate his victory. He's got to go right back into it and play against Skits, who I'm sure is looking to looking for the upset here.
Mm-hmm. And we're going to see Wario this time. I think Wario's a character that can deal with Peach being a bit slow a lot better because he has such great aerial momentum. He's able to drift in, drift out, kind of bait aggressiveness like in a similar way to Peach does. But at the same time, he can also get in on your shield and do quite a lot.
Nair already starting to put in a lot of work for Skits here. And falling up air. You know, even after the nerf to Wario, I think people really need to understand that this character, those were just privileges he had. This character is very much cracked when he wants to be.
Oh yeah, he's still great. Has amazing frame data, great aerial drift. When Wario's on your shield, that's tough. Like, so most characters just kind of have to hold that.
And Skits right now. Oh.
Off the bike.
Yep. Bounces off the bike. I don't think she wants to ride that. And Wario not very happy because now, going for the back air. And what I've been told is that Skits is in love with this back air, and I thought they were joking, but I saw him go for like four.
Yeah, the back air is super scary when you're at ledge because it's super strong. It can kill pretty easily, and it's relatively safe even when he lands it or whiffs it.
Oh, but good fair there from Oryx to catch this aerial approach.
Oh, 83 off of that dot
eyes. He knows his combos.
Oh God. That keto diet really hurt. Oh, the back air though, and that'll take it.
And when you think about it, basically all of this extra credit he got off of that one turnip combo. One. Peach is crazy, man.
Yeah, man. If anyone ever tries to downplay Peach, you immediately don't talk to them. Don't associate with them. They're probably Peach players.
Yeah, but Mario's definitely a character that can make the comeback. He's the comeback factor, man. Block isn't on deck yet. I think we got a few more seconds left.
Yeah, he's gonna have to. Oh, now it is. Uh-oh. He's ready to get trouble in class. He's ready to get sent to detention. Oh, goes for the fair here.
Ooh,
hungry.
Recent neutral get up with the bite. And Skits is an advantage here. Let's see what he can do.
Oh, God. Good spacing on the back air. Fair.
Norch is so good at just kind of taking his time to get in off the ledge.
Okay, so that's the second time that's happened. Like, Skits has gotten his stock taken in the same exact way. After he uses his bike, he's literally just standing there for a bit, and Oryx is hitting that 45-degree angle and hitting that fair. So Oryx, noticing this pattern from Skits.
Oh, he had another dot eye.
Oh, Winky. Oh, but gets the fair.
I believe he's gotten two dot eyes already. Good RNG this game. And a Saturn.
Oh, who wants to hold that? Nope, no one.
And Skits still has the great equalizer on deck, but he's going to need to take the stock before he can use it.
He just definitely does not want to open his bag of chips right now.
Absolutely, but this is where it's tough. When he has him at the ledge, Oryx is just so patient. He's not trying to, force his way in or get anything. He's just ready to play that waiting game.
But right now, what you're right, Skits is waiting. He's trying to get Oryx to commit to a really big button, but, Oryx just won't do it.
Yeah, and that just shows to the level of comfort that he has on his character, and especially even when he's in the corner against Wario. Wario can throw out so many moves so fast, but Oryx is not budging. He's not, trying to force his way. He's just taking it step by step.
Ah, there goes the back air.
Bear gonna take it.
And now this is this is a real danger zone. You do not want to get robbed by this character. Wario is looking to steal coins.
Yeah, oh, this could be one confirm away, I believe. Peach will probably die at like 30 if he gets the right hit of the wall.
Oh, I'm surprised that didn't kill.
Yeah, Wario's pretty heavy, but that nair definitely will.
Oh, yeah.
Oryx's gonna be taking that first game. I think that really the main points of that game was first stock started off with Oryx getting so much percent, and then on Skid's second stock he got that dot-eyed combo, and that was just so much of an uphill battle.
That did 80. Like one interaction. Stop. If I got hit by that, I wouldn't know how to feel. That.
I would feel bad. I would say no.
Oh man, that's just insane. And but you know what, Skits. He's made some good choices in the game. I just feel like it's just going to come down to a few interactions here. And something I've definitely noticed too is like Skits will hold on to his butter if he has to. He won't use it. He'll die before he just uses it mindlessly.
Yeah, you definitely want to always have that confirmed. When it's something like that and it's so good to have guaranteed, you definitely want to only use it when you're sure you got it.
Wow, that damage. He did like 50%. Wario can very much. Oh, he's hungry. Come here.
Yeah, he's been. I think that's the second time he's caught the neutral getup with the bite. He's pretty good at that. You know, just kind of recognizing the situation. And I think we're seeing a lot more of an even start to this game two than we were game one. I think in first game, Oryx took Skits to stock pretty fast, but he's still fighting here.
All right, goes for the air dodge, but Oryx is ready to read his landing option. Gets the back air, eats the bike.
Now Oryx off stage, gonna play this patient game.
I definitely would have let go of shield there.
Skits just kind of giving him the stage there with the dash back. Oryx taking it so slow. Oh, that killed him?
Yeah, I'm so surprised.
That was extended off the bike.
Yeah. I'm so surprised.
Oh, that's so tricky when she has the turn up and she can
still do the aerial.
He just
did it again and converted off the late hit of down air into fair. I didn't even know you could do that.
Yeah, and now we're seeing kind of a similar story to the first game with Oryx just running away with it. Skits needs to get something started here or it's going to look like curtains.
Dude, Skits is looking for these burst options. He wants the kill, and Oryx is hanging him out to dry, basically. Oh, goodness. Yeah.
Oh, and that's a Stitch Face. What's he going to do with it?
Oh, relax.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh,
80
my
damage.
God. Stop!
And Oryx up 3 stocks to 1.
Please stop! It was so gross.
This is tough. He still has the waft, but this is a whole universe to climb.
If I'm Skits, try to take this stock and then use it for the second stock and just pray that you literally have all the reach. Okay, it starts here. He could take the stock early and get to a third stock.
Definitely still winnable. Wario is for sure a character that can make crazy comebacks, but off stage, gonna go high.
Oh, gets the air dodge.
Oryx is doing such a great job at maintaining center stage when Skits is at these high percents. I feel like similar to the way that when Oryx is in disadvantage and, you know, just plays such a slow way to get out, I feel like Skits isn't really playing the disadvantage very slowly. He's kind of just trying to force his way in, and I think Oryx has caught him on that.
Yeah,
quite a few times.
But here we go. This is how you want to start. Skits, all right, here we go. Taking damage. I'm really surprised Skits wasn't going for these tomahawk grabs, because he had Oryx really respecting these short hop aerials.
That's going to be 2-0 from Oryx.